standing by, and welcome to PDD Holdings Inc. Second Quarter 2024 Earnings Conference Call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. There will be a presentation followed by a question-and-answer session, at which time, if you wish to ask a question, you will need to press star 1 on your telephone. Please be advised that today's conference is being recorded. I would now like to hand the conference over to your host today. Sir, please go ahead.
Thank you, operator. Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. PDD Holdings earnings release was distributed earlier and is available on our website at investor.pddholdings.com, as well as through the Globe Newswire services. Before we begin, I would like to refer you to our safe harbor statement in the earnings press release, which applies to this call, as we will make certain forward-looking statements. Also, this call includes discussions of certain non-GAAP financial measures. Please refer to our earnings release, which contains a reconciliation of non-GAAP measures to GAAP measures. Joining us today on the call are Mr. Chen Lei, our Chairman and Co-Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Zhao Jiazhen, our Executive Director and Co-Chief Executive Officer, as well as Ms. Liu Jin, our VP of Finance. Lei and Jiazhen will make some general remarks on our performance for the past quarter and our strategic focus. Jin will then walk us through our financial results for the second quarter ended June 30, 2024. During the Q&A session, Lei and Jiazhen will answer questions in Chinese and will help translate. Please kindly note that the English translation is for reference only, and in case of any discrepancy, statements in the original language should prevail. Now it's my pleasure to introduce our Chairman and Co-Chief Executive Officer, Mr. Chen Lei. Lei, please go ahead.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. Thank you all for joining our earnings call for the second quarter of 2024. In the first half of 2024, we have remained committed to our high-quality development strategy and consistently invested in our platform ecosystem. We received positive feedback for these efforts. Consumer experience and our services have continued to improve. A number of new merchants and products have grown significantly. This further meets the diverse needs of our consumers. This quarter, we benefited from the improving macro environment and achieved robust financial results. Our total revenues reached RMB 97 billion, which represents a year-on-year increase of 86%. However, we are seeing many new challenges ahead, from changing consumer demand, intensifying competition, and uncertainties in global environment. As a result, we will enter a new phase of high-quality development that calls for increased investments, and our profitability will affect it as a result. Since the beginning of this year, we are seeing that consumer preferences have become more diverse. On one hand, consumers are increasingly choosing experience-based consumption over material purchases. On the other hand, there is a growing emphasis on rational consumption. Consumers are making more thoughtful decisions to balance quality and value. In response, we have collaborated with high-quality brands and manufacturers to create customized products that cater to these diverse demands. This approach has not only propelled many new brands to success, but also revived the popularity of many established brands. And this is just one example of how digital technology and manufacturing can come together to create new opportunities. At this moment, the competition among e-commerce platforms is quickly escalating. And therefore, it's even more important that we go back to the basics of supply chain improvement and invest firm lead in supply chain efficiencies. This will be the key focus for our high-quality development going forward. For example, in the second quarter, our teams continued to bring our agriculture cloud initiative to major production regions, helping local growers to bring seasonal foods directly to people's homes. And in this process, promoted local agriculture brand. In addition, to further improve the agriculture supply chain, nurture research talents, and promote technology inclusion, we continue to support the Smart Agriculture Competition and the Pinduoduo Academy Growing Competition. The Agriculture Research Fund we established in cooperation with China Agricultural University has also started to bear fruit. On the manufacturing side, we are pleased to find that many small and medium-sized businesses have been using the digital capabilities from our platform to support product iteration and innovation. Through this process, they have not only emerged stronger from the competition, but also led the local industries towards high-quality development. These results have strengthened our commitment to further investing in high-quality development. We have communicated on a number of occasions that the profit growth in the past few quarters should not be used as a long-term guidance. And it is a result of mismatch between the business investment and the financial reporting cycles. As we enter a new investment phase, I would like to make it clear to our investors that our profits will gradually trend down starting in Q3, and there will be fluctuations or rebounds in the short term. In the long run, the decline in profitability is inevitable. Currently, our preference has reached a considerable scale. We will remain committed to high-quality development and focus on creating a healthy and sustainable platform ecosystem. And to this end, we will adopt the necessary policies to vigorously support high-quality merchants and tackle low-quality ones. On the supply side, we will invest substantial resources to support high-quality merchants who are willing to innovate and improve qualities. And we will offer significant transaction fee reduction to these merchants, with an initial target of $10 billion in the first year. By doing so, our goal is to provide clear initial incentives for the merchants to join high-quality development. On the other hand, we will further deepen our trust and safety capabilities to improve our merchant ecosystem and strengthen our supply chain. We are actively identifying and removing unlawful bad actors from our platforms, and we will continue to strengthen these efforts. At the moment, we have already started a new round of investments in operation and R&D to streamline the merchant onboarding and product listing process. Leveraging technology, we will gradually improve the quality of the products sold on our platforms and create a fair and transparent business environment for our merchants. In this process, we believe that sacrificing short-term profits is necessary. A clear downward trend in profits is expected. We are prepared to invest firmly and patiently in the platform's long-term health. This is a decision that has received unanimous support from all our management team. And now, moving on to the global business. In the past few quarters, we have noticed the rapid shifts in external environment, which brought significantly greater uncertainty. Our operations have also become increasingly affected by non-business factors. And meanwhile, the competition we face is growing stronger. Competition is here to stay and is expected to intensify in our industry. Our global business is facing significant uncertainties from intense competition and evolving external environment. These factors combined will inevitably cause fluctuations to our business. As shown in this quarter's results, high revenue growth is not sustainable and a downward trend in profitability is inevitable. And finally, as the environment evolves and our company continues to grow, the IR management team and I often discuss how we can better fulfill our corporate social responsibilities. We believe there is still many things that can be done, for example, through enhancing our governance structure and adjusting resources to better adapt to the changing times. We can also do more to give back to society, to support agriculture and other industry sectors, and offer greater support to the people who need it most. We fully recognize that simply measuring our company's performance by short-term capital returns no longer aligns with where we are today. As a global company in this era, we are committed to driving innovation, adapting to change, and taking on greater social responsibilities in the region across the globe. Now, I will hand it over to our co-CEO, Zhao Jiazhen, to talk more about our operations in the second quarter.
Thank you, Lei. Hello, everyone. This is Zhao Jiazhen. Thank you all for joining our earnings call for the second quarter of 2024.
今年上半年，国内线上零售的表现持续向好，为整体消费市场的回升注入了新的动能。过去的这一季度，我们继续深化落实高质量发展战略，坚定地进行长期投入，持续为平台的供需两侧带来普惠。展望下半年和中长期，我们对中国的消费市场非常有信心。
In the first half of this year, online retail in China continued to perform well, bringing fresh energy to the overall consumption market. Over the past quarter, we continued to advance our high-quality development strategy, making steady long-term investments to support both supply and demand sides of our platforms. Looking ahead to the second quarter of this year and beyond, we're very confident in the future of the China's consumer market.
本季度，我们继续以消费需求为导向，持续加码多实惠和好服务，不断完善升级售后服务体系，让消费者多得实惠和乐趣。618期间，我们秉承简单实惠的大促原则，推出多种购物新玩法，最大化满足了全域消费者日渐多样化的消费需求，也将生鲜、日用百货、高端家电等品类送入三四线城市。
This quarter, we continued to focus on consumer demand, further enhanced our more savings and better services capabilities, and upgraded our after-sale services to provide consumers with more value and more enjoyable shopping experiences. During the June 18th promotion, we continued to provide consumers with straightforward savings and introduced new promotions.To meet the increasingly diverse consumer preferences, we also brought product categories like fresh produce, daily necessities, and high-end appliances into third and fourth-tier cities, and made our contribution to consumption upgrades across the regions.
在供给侧，我们持续加大对优质商家品牌的扶持力度，百亿补贴。秒杀等流量引擎也进一步向优质好物进行倾斜，通过数字技术提升供应链上行的质量和效率，也让农产区产业带并成金产地，汇集更多优质的农货、国货以及产业带的商家。
On the supply side, we step up our support for quality merchants and brands, directing more traffic to high-quality products through the 10 billion program and fresh sales. We have also focused on enhancing the quality and efficiency of the supply chain, bringing more value to the agricultural areas and industry regions, and benefiting more producers of quality agricultural and domestic goods.
为了助力家电下乡，已交换新，百亿补贴仅在6.18手中就投入10亿元补贴，包括数码、家电、厨电、家居等在内的诸多国货品牌，因此实现了超额的增长。例如，蒙德成立了36年的国货老品牌，依托拼多多的数字技术，精准洞悉了新的市场需求，仅通过单款的爆品就实现了突破。店铺入驻平台2个月就卖出了1亿元。
To support the countryside home appliance program and the consumer goods trade-in, we invested 1 billion RMB during the first week of the June 18th. This boost led to remarkable growth for many local brands in categories such as electronics, home appliances, kitchenware, and household products. For example, utilizing our digital technology, we helped a local brand with 36 years of history to understand the latest market demands and return to growth with a blockbuster product. It achieved 100 million RMB in sales after joining the platform for just 2 months.
农产品商家数量同比增长83%， 数码、家电、美妆等多个类目的商家数量均保持高速增长。
In addition, the number of new merchants and new product supplies on our platforms saw meaningful growth. In the first week of June 18th, the number of merchants participating in the 10 billion program grew by over 90% year on year, and the number of agricultural merchants increased by 83% year on year. Our platform also attracted a great number of new merchants in categories such as electronics, home appliances, and cosmetics.
为了给优质商家营造更好的经营环境，我们在运营和研发上也进行了新一轮的投入，力争建设业内一流的合规能力和生态水平。比如，我们不断优化商家入驻和商品上架的流程， 严格把关商品质量，为消费者提供一个安全、放心的购物体验。
To create a better business environment for high-quality merchants, we have started a new round of investments in operations and R&D. Our goal is to build industry-leading compliance capabilities and foster a healthy platform ecosystem. For example, we continue to streamline our merchant onboarding and product listing processes to better control product quality and offer consumers a safe and reliable shopping experience.
我们通过技术手段对已经上架的商品进行主动的巡查，再结合我们的合规团队做精细化的审查，做到严格把关的同时，不误伤优质的商品和商家，把合规工作做到位。
We integrate automatic technology for product screening with thorough manual reviews by our trust and safety team. This approach ensures rigorous oversight on product compliance while avoiding unintended penalties for quality products and merchants.
同时，我们投入大量资源，制作丰富、详实且易懂的商家培训材料和视频，提升商家供应链整体的合规能力，助力商家降低合规成本的同时，也协助商家拓宽商品的适用市场，拓宽销路。
At the same time, we have invested heavily in developing comprehensive, user-friendly training materials for merchants to boost their compliance capabilities. This effort aims to enhance our supply chain quality while helping merchants lower compliance costs and expand their market reach.
当然，我们也深知建设完善的平台生态，实现高质量发展，并非一夕之功。 尤其是平台的整体规模已经有了相当的体量，为此我们将双管齐下，一方面大量扶持优质商家，另一方面坚持治理劣质商家，持续打造健康可持续的生态。We
also deeply recognize that building a healthy platform ecosystem and achieving high quality development is a gradual process, especially given the considerable scale of our platforms. so we are committed to a dual approach. One side, providing strong support to high-quality merchants while addressing issues with low-quality ones. This way, we aim to create a healthy and a sustainable ecosystem.
在这个过程中, 我们必然要付出短期的代价。正如陈磊所说的，管理层已经达成了共识， 愿意为长期的健康付出巨大的当下代价。未来几个季度的利润也许会有波动反弹，但长期利润降低的趋势是不可避免的。
In this process, we will inevitably face short-term costs. As Lei has mentioned, our management team is fully committed to investing heavily for the long-term health of our platforms. While profits might vary or even rebound in the next few quarters, it's unavoidable that profitability will trend lower over the long term.
作为国内最大的农产品上行平台，我们本季度继续深化农业战略，先后在云南大理、陕西佛坪山落地了科技小院项目，联合全球顶尖的科研团队，开启第四届多多农研大赛，持续加大农业投入，助力农业科研成果的转化应用，推动优质农产品加速上行。
As the largest platform for agricultural products in China, this quarter, we further advanced our agricultural strategy. We launched the Science and Technology Courtyard project in Yunnan, Dali, and Shanxi, Fuping, and also kicked off the fourth Smart Agricultural Competition in collaboration with top research teams from around the world. We will continue to increase investment in agricultural research to promote the commercial application of research funding and accelerate the market adoption of high-quality agricultural products.
与此同时，我们也充分发挥平台企业的优势，联合生态伙伴积极践行社会责任。第七次启动了多多读书月，投入近1元读书基金，结加官方补贴，对上万种图书产品进行源头滋补，让更多人能够享受知识普惠的福利。
Meanwhile, we also leverage our strength as a platform, working with ecosystem partners to proactively take on more social responsibilities. We invested tens of millions in reading funds and subsidies to launch the 7th Duoduo Reading Month. This initiative provides direct discounts on thousands of book products, making knowledge more accessible to more people.
2024年是我们落实高质量发展的重要一年。 我们将专注于平台生态健康长期发展，持续加大投入，为生态伙伴提供更多资源和技术支持，共同向高质量发展这个目标迈进。
2024 is a critical year on our path towards high quality development. We will focus on creating healthy and sustainable platform ecosystem and empowering our ecosystem partners with more platform resources and technical support. Together, we will lay a solid foundation towards the high-quality development of our platforms.
接下来，我把时间交给刘俊，由他为大家介绍一下我们二季度的财务表现。Next,
I will hand it over to Jun. She will provide an update on our financial performance for the second quarter.
Thank you, Jiajian. Hello, everyone. Let me walk you through our financial performance for the second quarter ended June 30th. 2024. In terms of income statements, in the second quarter, our total revenues increased 86% year-over-year to RMB 97.1 billion. This was mainly driven by an increase in revenues from online marketing services and transaction services. Revenues from online marketing services and others were RMB 49.1 billion this quarter, up 29% from the same quarter of 2023. Revenues from transaction services were RMB 47.9 billion, up 234% from the same quarter last year. In Q2, our top line growth slowed down significantly versus the last few quarters. Further slowdown is inevitable as a result of competition and global uncertainties. Moving on to cost and expenses. Our total cost of revenues increased 80% from RMB 18.7 billion in Q2 2023 to RMB 33.7 billion this quarter, mainly due to increase in fulfillment fees and payment processing fees. On a GAAP basis, total operating expenses this quarter increased 48% to RMB 30.8 billion. From RMB 20.9 billion in the same quarter of 2023. On non-GAAP basis, total operating expenses increased to RMB 28.4 billion this quarter, from RMB 19 billion in Q2 2023. In Q2, we continued to invest firmly to support the high-quality development of our platforms. Our total non-GAAP operating expenses as a percentage of total revenues this quarter was 29%, compared to 36% in the same quarter last year. Looking to specific expense items, our non-GAAP sales and marketing expenses this quarter were RMB 25.4 billion, up 54% versus the same quarter last year. Throughout Q2, we step up our promotional efforts to give back to consumers and invest in marketing to promote our platforms. On a non-GAAP basis, our sales and marketing expenses as a percentage of our revenues this quarter was 26%, versus 32% for the same quarter last year. Our non-GAAP general and administrative expenses were RMB 594 million, versus RMB 370 million in the same quarter of 2023. Our research and development expenses were RMB 2.4 billion this quarter on a non-GAAP basis, up 15% year-over-year, and RMB 2.9 billion on a GAAP basis. Critical that we maintain our long-term focus and continue to invest in R&D to drive supply chain efficiency and customer experience. On a GAAP basis, operating profit for the quarter was RMB 32.6 billion versus RMB 12.7 billion in the same quarter last year. Non-GAAP operating profit was RMB 35 billion versus RMB 14.6 billion in the same quarter last year. Non-GAAP operating profit margin was 36% this quarter, compared with 28% for the same quarter last year. Net income attributable to ordinary shareholders was RMB 32 billion for the quarter, compared to RMB 13.1 billion in the same quarter last year. Basic earnings per ADS was RMB 23.14, and diluted earnings per ADS was RMB 21.61, versus basic earnings per ADS of RMB 9.64 and diluted earnings per ADS of RMB 9 in the same quarter of 2023. Non-GAAP net income attributable to ordinary shareholders was RMB 34.4 billion. Versus RMB 15.3 billion in the same quarter last year. Non-GAAP diluted earnings per ADS was RMB 23.24 versus RMB 10.47 in the same quarter of 2023. As noted last quarter, our business does not follow a linear path, and the profitability in the last few quarters does not represent future. Looking ahead, we will invest firmly to support a healthy ecosystem that encourages high-quality merchants. Our profitability may fluctuate in the short term, but we are gradually trending lower in the long run. This is inevitable as we focus on the long-term high-quality development of our platforms. That concludes the income statements. Now, let me move on to cash flow. Our net cash generated from operating activities was RMB 43.8 billion, compared with 23.4 billion in the same quarter last year. As of June 30, 2024, we have RMB 284.9 billion in cash, cash equivalents, and short-term investments. Thank you. This concludes my prepared remarks.
Thank you, Jun. Next, we will move on to the Q&A session. In today's Q&A session, Lei, Jiazhen, and Jun will take questions from analysts on the line. We will take a maximum of two questions from each analyst. Lei and Jiazhen will answer questions in Chinese, and we will help translate for convenience purpose. Operator, we are open for questions.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. If you wish to ask a question, please press star one on your telephone and wait for your name to be announced. If you wish to cancel your request, please press star, then two. Participants are requested to restrict the number of questions to two at each time. Your first question comes from Joyce Ju from Bank of America. Please go ahead.
Lei, Jiazhen, Jun, 晚上好，感谢接受我的提问。第一个，我想请管理层分享一下，在我们这个季度的盈利增长态势很好的背景下，刚刚管理层有提到了未来因为一些大的投资支出和市场竞争的因素，公司的盈利水平会有波动。能不能就这个利润趋势跟我们分享一下，怎么样去理解短期和中长期的同比环比的影响？另外就是在股东回报方面，能不能麻烦管理层分享一下的未来的一个展望，以及对于未来的股东回报的一个预期。
I will translate for myself. I have two questions. My first question is, we have seen Duoduo's profit growth remain robust this quarter, but in the prepared remark, management mentioned there will be increased investment and profitability fluctuations caused by the competition. Could management share how you assess the profit trend in the future? In addition, in terms of shareholder returns, does management have any plan for share buyback or dividend payout? My second question is, in the prepared remark, we noted that management emphasized a lot on the merchant ecosystem and the merchant supporting policies. Could you please elaborate a bit on your understanding on the healthy merchant ecosystem, how to review it, how to understand it, and why this will become the focus of the platform in the next stage? Thanks a lot.
Joyce，你好，我是陈磊。
Hi, this is Chen Lei. Let me take your first question.
那么我们过去一段时间呢，曾多次地强调，过去几个季度利润的增长是短期投入的周期和财报周期不同步的结果，不能够作为长期的指引。
We have communicated on a number of occasions that the profit growth in the past few quarters should not be used as long-term guidance, and it was the result of the mismatch between the business investment and financial reporting cycles.
那么此外呢，当前我们的业务正在面临激烈的竞争和一些外部的环境因素的影响，那么这些呢，将必然为我们的业务的发展带来波动，那么收入的增长呢，也会放缓。
In addition, our business is currently facing intense competition and shifting external factors, which will inevitably bring fluctuations to our business and also slow down our top-line growth.
那么当前呢，我们处于坚定的转型、高质量发展的新阶段，我们需要耐心地在有利于平台长远健康发展的方向呢，加大投入。那么为了支持平台生态的可持续发展，那么在未来的10到20年内呢，我们将继续投入，并且加大投入的力度。
接下来呢，我们短期的利润也不排除会有波动，但是利润逐渐下降的大方向是不可避免的。 We are now entering a new phase of steady transformation towards high-quality development, and we need to invest patiently in the platform's long-term health. And to support a sustainable development of our platform ecosystem, we will invest substantial resources over the next 12 months to support high-quality merchants. And looking ahead, our profitability may fluctuate in the short run, but directionally, it will gradually enter a downward trend.
而对于商家的赋能和反哺是构建我们推进高质量供给的建设和搭建高质量平台生态的重要环节。那长期来看呢，是能够促进平台形成正向的生态循环。那么因此呢，即使短期内的利润会受到影响，我们仍然会坚定地做出耐心的投入。
Empowering and supporting merchants is crucial to building our high-quality supply chain and also creating a robust platform ecosystem. Over the long run, this will start up a virtuous cycle for the platform. And therefore, we will remain committed to patient investments, even though short-term profits will be affected.
那么对于股东回报方面呢，我们觉得当前公司仍然处于投入的阶段，那公司业务呢在多线都面临着激烈的竞争和外部环境所带来的不确定性。因此呢，我以及其他的管理层，我们都一致的认为，那么在当前进行资本层面的回购或者分红是不合适的。那在我们管理层可预见的未来几年，我们呢也觉得没有这方面的必要。谢谢。
In terms of shareholder returns, the company is still in the investment phase, and we are facing intense competition on different fronts and also uncertainties from external factors. And therefore, our management team and I unanimously believe that it is not an appropriate time for share repurchases or dividends. And in the foreseeable years ahead, we also do not see such a need. Thank you.
你好，我是戴亚珍。 由我来回答一下有关商家生态的问题啊。
Hi, this is Zhao Jiazhen. Let me take your question on merchant ecosystem.
我们的平台呢是由这个商家、用户、运营人员一起组成的一个相互依存的社区。商家是我们共同服务好消费者的重要伙伴。Our
platform is a mutually dependent community of merchants, consumers, and our operation teams. Merchants are our key partners in our joint effort to serve consumers.
当前呢，这个行业的竞争加剧，那也对我们这个社区呢提出了新的要求。在这个过程中，那作为平台，我们自己是感到责任非常的重。一方面呢，我们要严格把关商品的质量问题，杜绝以次充好，保障消费者的权益；另一方面呢，我们要做到公平公正，让认真做生意的高质量商家。
The increased competition in our industry brings new demands on our community. In this process, we feel a strong sense of responsibility as a platform. On one side, we must ensure strict oversight of product quality to prevent substandard goods and protect consumer rights. On the other side, we must ensure fairness so that dedicated high-quality merchants can earn meaningful rewards, which is essential for the healthy development of platform ecosystems.
为了找到这个生态的平衡，我们没有其他的选择，只有坚定的转型高质量发展。为此呢，大力的扶持和坚决的治理将是我们接下来的双重策略。在供给侧，我们一方面将投入100亿资源。 大力的扶持具有产品技术创新能力的这个新质商家和新质产业带，大幅度的减免优质商家的交易手续费。未来的一年呢，我们预计会减免100亿，并持续的加强高质量生态发展的这个正向激励。To
achieve balance in the ecosystem, we have no choice but to firmly transition towards high quality development. Therefore, we will adopt the necessary policies to provide strong support to high-quality merchants while tackling low-quality ones. On the supply side, we will strongly support merchants with product and technology innovation capabilities. We will significantly reduce transaction fees for these high-quality merchants with an expected amount of 10 billion RMB in the following year. We will continue to enhance incentives for the merchants to drive our high-quality development of ecosystem.
另一方面呢，我们也将坚决地进行平台和商家的生态治理，打击不法的作弊商家，推动产业链去无存精。 进一步优化升级供应链。目前呢，我们在运营和研发上已经进行了新的一轮投入，优化商家入驻和商品上架的流程，并且通过技术手段严格把关商品质量，给优质商家营造更好的经营环境。On
the other side, we will further enforce strong governance of our platform and merchants. This includes identifying and removing unlawful merchants from our platforms to strengthen our supply chain. As of now, we have already started a new round investment in operations and technology to optimize the merchant onboarding and product listing processes. Use advanced technology to ensure strict product quality control and create a better environment for our high-quality merchants.
我们与优质商家伙伴共同成长，一起为平台的消费者提供优质的产品和服务。 而满意的消费者又能为整体生态带来源源不断的动力，这是一个正向的循环，是我们这个社区长期健康发展的关键。We
grow together with our high-quality merchant partners, working together to offer consumers high-quality products and services. The consumers can in turn bring new growth opportunities to the ecosystem, creating a virtuous cycle, which is the key to the long-term healthy development of our community.
为了实现商家生态高质量发展这个目标，管理层已经达成了共识，将坚定地做长期的投入，创造健康可持续的平台生态。谢谢。To
achieve the goal of high-quality development of the merchant ecosystem, our management has reached the consensus to firmly commit to long-term investments and create a healthy, sustainable platform ecosystem. Thank you all.
Operator, let's move on to the next analyst on the line.
Thank you. The next question is from Yang Bai from CICC. Please go ahead.
谢谢管理层，我有两个问题。第一个是有关国际业务方面的。我们看到近期呢，公司国际业务整体扩张依然非常迅速，但是从一些外部数据看呢，在个别市场的增速跟投入似乎有一定的放缓。从管理层的发言中，我们也注意到。 当前公司对全球化业务未来的发展也有不少相对谨慎的考量。那么公司是否在有意的控制一些风险？能否请管理层进一步谈谈这方面的想法？然后第二个问题是有关国内。我们观察到当前国内电商行业整体的竞争环境依然比较激烈，是否会影响到公司的增长？在这样的竞争环境中，公司投入的侧重点会有什么变化？ 以及公司是如何定位自己的？我来翻译一下。Thank you, management. I have two questions. The first one is, we have observed that the growth of your global business remains strong. Some external data suggests that the growth rate and the investment in certain markets are slowing down. In your prepared remark, we also noted that the company takes a relatively cautious approach towards the future development of your global business. Is the company trying to manage some risks proactively? Could the management please elaborate on your thinking in this regard? The second one is, we saw that the overall competitive environment is quite intense. Has this caused any impact on the company's growth? In such a competitive environment, how will the company adjust your investment priorities, and how does the management think about your position? Thank you.
Hi,
this is Lei. Let me take your question on the global business.
全球化的业务的形态呢，其实我们还是在不断迭代的。
那么我们还在不断地积极探索。那么当前我们的全球化业务已经进入了70多个市场。那么在业务拓展的过程中，我们始终将合规视为发展的重要前提。在过去一段时间，我们投入了大量的资源，力求建设安全放心的购物环境。
Global business is still evolving, and we are actively exploring new opportunities. Currently, our global business has entered over 70 markets, and during this growth, we have always prioritized compliance and see it as the foundation for our development. Over the past few quarters, we have invested significant resources in building a safe shopping environment.
那么随着业务的发展，我们感受到外部环境的变化正在加速。那么随着行业的变化，我们也在不断地适应。
As our business develops, we have noticed that changes in the external environment are accelerating, and our operations are increasingly affected by some non-business factors, and we are seeing a significant increase in uncertainty. Meanwhile, competition is a constant theme in the e-commerce industry and is expected to intensify. At this moment, such intense competition, combined with the impact of external factors, will inevitably lead to disruptions on our global business. But nevertheless, we remain committed to our vision of allowing more consumers worldwide to enjoy the benefits of the digital economy, and this has not changed.
面对复杂的环境，我们仍然会专注自身，持续地在供应链能力、服务能力、合规能力等方面持续地投入和优化，那么从而积极地响应各国消费者对我们提出的需求。实现我们全球化业务的高质量发展。谢谢。
In response to the complex environment, we will focus on our core strength and continue to improve our capabilities in supply chain, customer services, and compliance, to better meet the expectations of consumers around the world and also achieve high quality development in our global business. Thank you.
你好，我是戴亚珍，由我来回答一下有关竞争的问题。
Hi, this is Zhao Jiazhen. Let me take your question on competition.
在过去的几个季度，整体的竞争环境是在不断地加剧的。那竞争作为这个电商行业的主旋律，我们觉得是不可避免的。在这样的激烈的竞争环境下呢，我们的营收增长可能会放缓。那比如刚过去的二季度呢，我们的收入增速呢就显著的下滑。那这也说明呢，高收入的增长呢其实是不可持续的。
Over the past few quarters, the competition has been intensifying, which is natural to the e-commerce sector. In such a competitive environment, our revenue growth may slow down. For instance, in the second quarter, our revenue growth has declined, indicating that high revenue growth is not sustainable.
当前，消费的需求也趋向于多元化，各个电商平台都在积极调整自身的策略来适应这个消费者的消费需求。那各个平台都有各自的资源和实力，为了满足消费者的需求，投入了大量的资源。这个时候，我们更加应该需要修炼基本功，扎实地执行高质量发展的战略。
Currently, consumer demand is becoming more diversified, and e-commerce platforms are actively adjusting their strategies to meet these evolving needs. Each platform has its own strength and competitive edge, and commits substantial resources to cater to consumer demands. At this moment, we need to focus on our core strength and continue on our path to high-quality development.
那对于电商平台来说呢，强供应链是服务好消费者的前提。那为了满足消费者日益多元化的需求，我们将这个一如既往的回归根本，在供应链上努力创新。在第二季度，我们的农云行动继续深入了各大农产区，帮助特色农产品打响产地的品牌，为中小农产品商家形成传播的合力。
For e-commerce platforms,A robust supply chain is essential to providing good services to consumers. To meet the diversified needs of consumers, we remain focused on the fundamentals and strive for innovation in the supply chain. In the second quarter, our teams continue to bring agricultural core initiatives to major production regions, helping local agricultural products build their brands and empowering small and medium-sized agricultural merchants through collective marketing efforts.
在农产品之外呢，我们也进一步的向制造业的产业链进行数字化的赋能，联合优质的农货产业带的商家，针对某些细分品类，成功的推出了定制化的产品。通过不断的技术迭代和产品创新，这些品牌商家都实现了更高质量的发展。
Apart from agricultural products, we have expanded our support to the manufacturer through digitalization.By collaborating with high-quality national brands and manufacturers, we have successfully launched tailored products for niche categories. These brands and merchants have achieved higher quality development through continuous technological updates and product innovation.
针对认真做生意、积极创新的优质商家，我们接下来将会大力度的鼓励和扶持。除了我们刚刚提到的，在未来12个月。为优质商家大幅度的减免交易手续费，我们还会持续通过平台自身的供应链能力，助力商家提质增效，推动制造业商家走向创新升级的高质量发展道路。
We will strongly encourage and support high-quality merchants who are dedicated to their business and innovation, in addition to the significant reduction in transaction fees that we plan to offer.We will continue to leverage our platform's supply chain capabilities to help merchants improve quality and efficiency and guide manufacturers towards innovative and high-quality development.
我们深刻地认识到，只有通过供给端的优化升级，为满足消费者深层次需求打下的坚实的基础，才能促成平台生态的长远健康发展。在这方面，我们会做长期耐心的投入。
We fully understand that only by optimizing and upgrading the supply chain is essential to meeting deeper consumer needs and ensuring the long-term healthy growth of our platform ecosystem. We're committed to making long-term and patient investments. Thank you all.
Thank you, Jiazhen. And thank you all for joining us today. We look forward to speaking with you again next quarter. And thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That does conclude our conference for today. Thank you for participating. You may all now disconnect.